This is the JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
That's right.
Oh, that feels good.
My Johnny Broken Boots. Got that mouth harp.
That was pretty cool. They
kind of slightly queer lyrics.
They put. they put.
Fine.
Well, everybody's thinking it, but that's all right. You can just go. I thought it was cool in the movie. What was the name of the stupid movie?
Young Guns.
Yeah, Young Guns. They.
Hold on a second.
Yeah,
let's
know.
Take a minute.
Hey, I'm not functioning.
I believe this is the first time ever
right.
where you've asked me what's the name of that movie,
you
and
got
I
it.
Effing actually knew it.
Right. I'm on an antibiotic, so I'm slow this week. I can't. I cannot do anything on my own this week. My nerves are frayed. I thought it was really cool, though, that they used John Bon Jovi as an extra and blew him away in the movie. I thought that was pretty cool. Because you could totally tell it was John. You could see his face. You're like, oh, they're going to blow him away.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he didn't get to talk, but they made room to blow Bon Jovi away. I thought that was pretty badass.
It was pretty badass. Emilio Estevez.
Emilio Estevez.
What happened?
What?
I can't.
Yeah. You know, it'd be funny if there were, well, we have six listeners. If all eight of us all went, where's Emilio? Where's Emilio?
Yeah.
Anybody check on him lately?
I don't think so.
I think, if I remember right, he just quit. Everything.
And he was like, I'm just going to hang out with my family.
Well, his dad, you know.
Yeah.
Marty. Yeah, I think he's done. If anybody's got a word on Emilio Estevez, who I actually love. Love that dude.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, you ever see St. Elmo's Fire?
No.
Really?
Yeah.
See, you'd like that. I think you would have fun with that movie. It's a time capsule.
Yeah.
Of the 80s. I think you'd love it. You check that out,
so,
Demi Moore, Rob Lowe.
It says here, so I'm on Screen Rant.
Mm-hmm.
Emilio Estevez hasn't been in the Hollywood spotlight for years, leading many to question what happened. But while he stayed out of the limelight, he hasn't been inactive. Estevez carved a unique path through Hollywood, which included working off-screen as a producer, writer, and director.
There we go.
Though he hasn't completely stopped taking on-screen roles, Estevez has been highly selective. A natural course for someone who's spent more than 40 years in the entertainment industry. Yeah, no kidding. So he's been doing off-screen stuff. Let's see. What has he written?
Man, I think we need somebody like Tarantino to resurrect Emilio Estevez, like he did with.
Okay. His next film appearance was supposed to be in Guns 3, alias Billy the Kid.
Oh, really?
And he is most likely tending to various other production duties as the movie's writer and director.
Well, last time we saw him in Young Guns, he was 98 years old trying to get a pardon. You remember
right?
that?
Yeah.
He came in from the sand dunes.
Yeah.
And he probably didn't survive the scene. He was so old.
They don't know if him and Charlie Sheen are talking at all. All right. Well, there you go. Emilio. Still
right.
doing stuff.
All right. Pray for Emilio.
Okay. PC2. Back to Bon Jovi. Oh, I have cicadas going.
Oh, the cicada. That's pretty cool. Nate wanted to hear cicadas all morning, so we're we got it on hot standby over here. May pop up from.
There's a new 4-part documentary, Thank You, Good Night,
yep.
The Bon Jovi Story. Started streaming today on Hulu.
Oh, good.
In the first episode, John Bon Jovi tells a story about how every record company turned him away. So he took it upon himself to get his first song, Runaway, on the radio. And he basically credits a couple DJs for his career.
And I said, who's the loneliest man in the music business? The DJ. There was a new radio station in New York City.
W-A-P-P.
W-A-P-P. And fortunately for me, a young guy by the name of John Lastman and a guy named Chip Hobart, who was the DJ on the air, played him Runaway, and he said, that's a hit song. But the miracle of miracles happened. Doubleday, the book publisher, they owned 8 radio stations in some big markets. They started playing Runaway on all 8 stations.
And all of a sudden, from getting turned down by every record company, we were the most requested song.
Yeah.
Imagine now you don't have to go through the corporate BS of trying to get a song on the radio. Imagine that.
Yeah.
Wow, what a crazy, wacky way to play music.
Amen, John.
Looks good. I can't wait to see it.
One of the two DJs that he gives credit to is Johnny Rock Lastman, who currently does mornings and is an OM, which is operations manager, at WHMH. Rocket 101 in Minnesota.
Cool.
So he's still in the biz.
But what? Twin Cities?
I don't know.
I've never heard those calls before.
Hey, it's been Deathly Pallor coming at you on number 902 WA3DFM, The Stern. Coming up next, we got some hot new tracks from Triple Who, Blabby Who.
Sauk Rapids, Minnesota.
Never heard of it.
Yeah.
Weird.
Near St. Cloud, I guess.
So is that, I missed that. Were they a regional company, more of a Midwest?
Where he first started?
No, the company, one of the, part of the eight, were they more of a Midwest company?
That I don't know.
I missed that part.
I don't know. Who's the loneliest people in the music
industry?
Yeah,
what is that all about? Is that just for the guy sitting at night playing music at 8 o'clock or midnight or something?
Sad.
I don't feel lonely. I don't know. If I was here alone, I'd feel lonely.
Right.
Never thought of myself as lonely.
I know, me neither. Then Bon Jovi's like, DJs are lonely. And I'm like, am I?
Yeah. He's. There are a couple of songs, lyrics out there that refer to lonely DJs, I believe. And Bret Michaels, what he sing... But does he know? I call my DJ, but does he know how I really feel? Give me something to believe in. That was a lyric. But there was a song, oldies, like 60s or something, 70s, about a guy that calls the DJ, and the DJ sad.
Why are we sad? I'm not sad. Yeah, what's the DJ line from the Poison song?
I think I just sang it. But does he know how I feel? Has he ever had a sign, bro? I'm going to call a request line. We call over 9 with some tickets to the Monster Truck Show. But does he know that I'm calling now? Yeah. No. DJ songs. Well, I don't.
Yeah.
Well, don't. Well, we're not lonely.
Yeah, don't worry about us.
We're not sitting here with the candle burning. You know.
Yeah, I don't know. This is going to be hard. Songs about radio DJs.
I did like the beginning, the trailer of the Bon Jovi special, though. Richie Sambora sitting there, and I'm like, we telling the truth, or we're going to lie about all this crap? What version you want? I'm like, all right, this will be good.
On the radio, Cheap Trick, Mr. Radio, Last Radio, Around the Dial, The Kinks.
You know who would be lonelier than a DJ? I mean, we have the request line. Would be a guy like sitting in a guard at a gate somewhere at a industrial park. That'd be a lonely guy. We're not lonely because we rock. Yeah.
Who's lonelier than a DJ?
Who's lonelier than a DJ? That's the question I'd like to answer today. Who's lonelier? 3210941. Who's lonelier than a DJ?
How did we get that reputation of being lonely?
How about a guy?
Like you said, because we go to the phones. You know, like you always have the phones to go to if you're lonely.
What are the loneliest jobs in America?
Yeah.
Can you think?
Man. I mean, I would. Security guard, like you said,
security
like a third
guard.
Shift security
guard. Like the guy in the rent-a-cop truck driving around the Westtown Mall parking lot.
Right.
That is a lonely-ass job, dude. You're just praying somebody tries to break in so you can billy club somebody. I don't know. That's a lonely job.
I guess Emilio Estevez was in the last episode of 2.5 Men. A great movie about a DJ is On the Line with Mel Gibson on Netflix. Thank you, Farmer. Hey. Well.
Yes.
Oops.
Yes.
Loneliest job in America.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. I think he's it. I think.
Truck driver.
Truck driver would be lonely. But you've got the DJ to keep you company. See? It's all seven.
It's a symbiotic relationship, John.
What about like an overnight machinist or something? You're just at a machine all night.
And there's other people around you. But I suppose you can still be lonely with other people around you.
Yeah. But being lonely doesn't mean you're sad. I mean, I don't know why he ties in. It almost makes it sound like we're depressed.
Yeah. Sounds kind of judgy.
So it makes our job sound pathetic. I mean, we're not here by accident.
I said, who's the loneliest man in the music business?
Oh, the music business. Sorry.
What the hell?
I suppose. I take great offense to that.
I do, too.
I mean, I didn't get here by accident. I mean, you think these pipes are an accident?
You can learn a lot listening to podcasts.
And only three countries in the world don't use the metric system?
Or you can listen to this one.
I can't remember where I went Friday. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. What did I do on Friday? I got to check my calendar.
If anybody saw me Friday, call.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
I literally have no idea where I was Friday.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
A British man ran a distance of 1 mile through the water in a swimming pool in an attempt to break a Guinness World Record. How long do you think it would take you to run a mile in the pool?
How deep's the water? Is it up to his neck? Or is it a waist high?
That's a good question. It looks like it's about. It looks like it's up to his chest.
Wow, how long would it take to run back and forth? Okay, so a mile. Jeez, how many laps is that? That's a lot. I don't know. 10 minutes?
Adam Lopez, 37, ran 63 laps in the 82-foot pool.
Having a heart attack just listening to that.
Newfield Health in Norwich, England, on Tuesday with a time of 35 minutes and 24 seconds.
Okay.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
So he beat the current Guinness World Record by 4.5 minutes. So holy crap.
Yeah, that's...
But I mean, that would be so hard.
So you're going as fast as you can, which is to say not very fast.
Right. Totally.
Yeah, I guess. God, I didn't even know. What a weird record.
Right? That's what I thought too. I'm like, that's kind of record.
I wondered if the standard is you know, he was up to his chest, like an Olympic. Did you say an Olympic pool?
I was at a health club, but it looks like it's up to his chest.
Yeah, because I was thinking of the Princeton Club pool, because that's, I see people stand up, it's about chest high, I think.
Yeah.
So I guess that's about normal for
That would be hard as hell.
That would be something I'm not interested in, to be quite honest with you. No. I prefer the hot tub. Right. I prefer moving seats in the hot tub to adjust.
Where's my floaty?
Where's my wine
glass? I need a floaty record.
I lost my wine glass. Where is it? Yeah, no. No, I have no interest in it.
Now, this is kind of cool. Lopez said he started exercising in the pool after being diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. Mm. When someone tells you that your life's under threat, it changes your complexion on how you look at your mortality. Sometimes we take our lives for granted and our health for granted, and we shouldn't. We should look after ourselves, look after our body, because it's the only place you've got to live. Oh, good for you, dude. The record attempt raised money for a 5-year-old girl named Grace, who was diagnosed with spinal muscular atrophy.
Oh.
So the money will go toward home upgrades for the girl, including a hydrotherapy pool. Look at this guy.
Look at you go.
He is awesome.
Look at you go.
So, dude, Adam Lopez, 37 years old, from England. Nice work, buddy.
So the aqua jog is a thing.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Tell me more. Okay, every day I'm like, there's so much I just don't know.
Yeah, I see them do... I'll look at in the Princeton Club pool here in the West Side, because I'm always expecting like a Bo Derek to come out of the pool in a bikini, but no,
it's not what happens.
It's never actually happens. But yeah, they're doing like flexibility. It's amazing. They just do everything you would do, but they do it in a pool. So I would assume that resistance.
Yeah.
To add a little more resistance, cardiovascular balance, you know, as you get older.
I would assume if you're like out of water runner, running in water would still help you.
Well, it would be easier on your joints, I would think.
Yeah.
You know?
I like joints.
Yeah. I don't know what that means, but that's fine. Yeah, you get your noodle and hit the pool. And they're fanatical at the pool.
I like watching.
They are committed. I'll give them that.
Like the older ladies will go in there for their aqua aerobics.
Yeah, they're
super into it. And it always makes me happy. Like, good for you girls. Keep it going. Move it or lose it, man. And that's so true. If you don't move around and keep active, it's a quick downhill.
You know, when you hear that number, it seems like a long time.
Right, but then you think about how hard it would be. I mean, how many laps was it? 63 laps.
Yeah.
Like walking like funny. 3 laps like that would be hard.
I was thinking we were just in Turks on the cruise, and we got off on the island, and I was out there with my cocktail. There's the real balancing training right there without spilling your cocktail. And I was walking. I remember walking back and forth. I don't know why I was doing that. I was fighting a little undercurrent as well. It was the ocean.
Man.
Yep. And
walking.
I remember. Baby steps. Baby steps. And I remember that. I think about it. I was up to my chest. I mean, it was almost up to my neck, but how hard that really is.
Yeah.
That really is difficult, just keeping your balance and momentum. That's difficult.
Totally. The turn, like, the momentum is key. So he's doing laps. So, like, when he turns around, that water is still going that way that's true. That's,
and I wonder if he's allowed to use his arms in any way.
Right.
To propel himself.
Or can you just do the jog motion?
Or is that it? I mean, I bet you cannot use your hands
like a swim motion at all.
As part
the water.
Right, right.
Yeah. Damn. It'd
be funny if they strapped his arms to his chest.
Or like to his sides.
It'd be difficult.
I don't know.
That'd be hard enough. It's hard enough to do with your arms. Yeah. All right, that's a good record.
Yeah, dude, I approve.
Cool.
It's weird, like, until you sit and really think about it, because you think, oh, we're running a mile, whatever.
Well, think of the leg burn you would get.
Dude, blast them quads.
Oh, my Lord. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would take a lot of training.
Mm-hmm.
And a thinner guy would be probably a better motion through the water. Is there a picture of it?
Yeah, he's a beefier dude.
Oh. I love beefy dudes.
I know you do, sir.
Oh, my God. He's huge.
Shut up. He's trying. He's trying. And he's doing. He got diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, and he decided he was going to do something about it.
I mean, if you're going to do being in the pool all day, working on your health, why not? I mean, have a goal, man.
The only thing about being in the pool all day is a wrinkly skin.
That's a fact.
You know?
Yeah.
Which I had read somewhere, and I don't know how true this is, but I had read that your skin gets wrinkly in the water. It's a defense mechanism for your body so that you can still grip stuff.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No kidding?
Isn't that crazy?
I did not know that. I wonder if he trained using ankle weights.
Yeah.
You know, because with my golf clubs, when I warm up, I'll grab 3 clubs and swing them all together. So there's some resistance there. Does that make sense to you?
It does make sense to me. Thank you.
Are you familiar with one of the great songs ever, dude?
I can't wait for this. Well, if I could walk on underwater.
Okay, let me start over. I gotta improvise. Well, if I could walk underwater. And if I could
find some way to prove, why do I know this song?
Eddie Money, baby.
Okay.
Believe in me. My love is so true.
I like songs with na-na-na-na's.
The late, great Edwin Money. Love that dude. One of my favorites.
Replay today. The JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
Okay, we haven't had a kid stuck in a claw machine in a while, so...
Been a minute.
It's only a matter of time. Firefighters freed a young boy stuck in a laundromat teddy bear claw machine Tuesday afternoon. It always goes down out of the laundromat, dude. Stabbings, claw machines.
I've heard, yeah.
Yeah.
Prostitution.
Firefighters responded to the New Britain Avenue business on Tuesday for a report of a child stuck in a vending machine. The kid was quickly removed and no injuries reported. The kid was, quote, trying to get a stuffed animal and got stuck inside the machine.
This image of them pulling him out by his leg, one leg stuck.
Just with the claw. Once removed, he was allowed to take as many stuffed animals as he wanted. Well, that's dumb. You're reinforcing the behavior. You're like, hey, you crawled into a claw machine and you get four teddy bears.
It would be funny if the firefighters were standing there whispering, bet you $20 you can't claw his head. I bet you can't get that claw on his head.
Right.
$20.
Man, oh man. Yeah, the boy walked away uninjured with four stuffed animals.
That's so funny.
I'd be like, nah, you get a small animal from the bottom shelf.
Right.
You know, come on now.
Grounded.
We don't want to teach. He's three, so.
Yeah, you're encouraging. Yeah. Yeah, you broke the law, kid. I mean, I know you're too stupid to know what that means, but
yeah.
You still broke the law.
Okay.
No F's to give, dude. He's like, screw it. I'm gonna cut out the middleman. I'm going in.
I have a panda attack story, too.
Yeah, you do.
Now, we talked about pandas kind of being dicks before. That's how we got on. Was it the red panda when it attacks? How cute it is. Well, this is a black and white panda.
It's the big mean one, right?
Yeah. A zookeeper at a Chinese zoo. Footage shows the pandas running towards the zookeeper as she appears with snacks.
Probably a bad idea.
One of them biting at her ankles, and another one knocks her to the ground. They were totally in cahoots together.
Jesus.
Both animals climb over the terrified zookeeper and quickly bury her underneath them as they paw at her head.
Yeah, they're bears. I mean, what are you confused about? They're bears. Maybe not walk around the panda exhibit covered in chocolate. I love beefy dudes.
I know you do,
sir. Oh, my God, he's huge. Did you just do? Well, you are sick.
Me and Trevor work together.
You guys are sick, and you ought to focus.
Very attractive, man.
You guys, listen. If you guys focused on your jobs,
I prefer the ding dong.
Listen to me. If you guys would focus on your jobs and responsibilities, maybe we could present a better show for the people.
I do like the ding dong.
Why is my wiener so small? You guys are so weird. You know, that's all you think about. It's really weird. And those are
very attractive, man.
Listen. That's all out of context, all edited together, separate words, edited together.
That's where you get screwed up. There's too many balls.
Well, that sounded not gay. I mean,
but, hang on. I got some more gay stuff just around the corner.
All right.
Guys are sick. There will be, I'm going to go see HR.
You're going straight. I'm turning gay.
I'm ruined. Wait till my wife hears about this. Oh, no. She's like, I've heard some rumors. Heard some sound effects. Now, what's going on?
Oh, AI's got nothing on Trevor.
God, no kidding.
Okay, anyway, the helpless worker rolls from side to side, hoping to get the massive pandas off. Oh, you don't want to get them off. You want to get them off of you.
Yeah, you think it'd be cute and cuddly. But no, he's mauling your face off.
They're assholes.
Yeah, they're not to be toyed with.
So the other one holds her down and gnaws at her midriff. And like, people are at the zoo.
Zombie panda, dude.
Attacks like this are highly unusual, and pandas seldom attack people or other animals, not knowing what caused the attack, other than they wanted some goddamn snacks. Yeah. Bears, this just in. Bears will kill you. When she finally manages to get up, the zookeeper has a rip in her shirt as well as scratch marks on her shoulder. Colleague ran out to help her, but was quickly chased off by the animal himself. The clip ends with both workers scrambling to safety in the enclosure.
Jesus.
And the panda is still chasing. I guess she only sustained minor injuries.
But they don't attack like a black bear or a grizzly. I mean, they're more like... They kind of look like they're cuddling, but they're biting you, right?
Right.
Yeah. So it'd be like the cutest way to die ever.
Dude, a comment on this story is so dumb.
Is it pandemonium?
I cannot bear this any longer.
Have you ever seen a panda move quickly? Because I don't think I have. Do they move? Can they move what they want to? I suppose they're like, oh my God, how'd he get there so fast?
Just at top speed, 20 miles an hour.
That's enough to...
A giant panda can run faster than many humans, right. But they're not built for stamina. Neither is your ma.
Good.
Yeah. Oh, lie. Look at that thing go. Holy crap. All right, well.
It still amazes me that zookeepers still get caught or bit or caught in an enclosure.
Right.
You'd think there'd be like backup saying, you know, he's in the holding pen.
Well, that was like the gorilla one, right?
Yeah.
You know, that was a close call.
Don't you think?
Yeah.
And then why does the, just for backup, why don't they have a stun gun or a something, anything, a noisemaker, something, a horn, air, truck horn.
Blow dart.
Blow dart. Hello, blow darts. Shot myself in the neck once. He's like, yes! Yes, it's the most powerful tranquilizer gun in the world! Anyways. Old school.
Yeah.
Best scene in the movie. I have to say, the girth was impressive. What are you... I'm calling HR. I mean, I am a little... I feel like I'm... being attacked.
Aww.
I feel like I'm being bullied.
But... You're the loneliest man in the music industry.
Dumbing down your smartphone. One podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe to the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
I love cats. I love every kind of cat. I just want to hug all of them, but I can't get hug every cat. Cat. So anyway, I am a cat lover and I love to run. I'm sorry I'm thinking about cats again. I really love cats. I'm thinking about cats again.
Oh yeah.
A couple in Utah is thrilled to be reunited with their cat Galena, who mysteriously disappeared 2 weeks ago.
I love Galena in the spring.
Yes. They looked all over for her. They put up the signs in the neighborhood, but it turns out Galena did not run away. The couple actually shipped her to Amazon.com on accident. PC2. All right, let's see. Here they are. Here's Carrie Clark and her husband explaining what the hell happened.
We got the most amazing, insane news in the entire world. I just couldn't even believe that she was in California. I thought it was a prank. Like, I still hard to wrap my brain around. She was trapped in an Amazon package.
And it was in this really big sized Amazon package.
We had no idea. So Matt took the package to the drop off without knowing that our dear cat was inside.
How's that possible?
Well, you know.
How is that? I would do not let them reproduce. Ship their baby to Amazon.
It reminded me of Garfield used to ship Nermal to Abu Dhabi.
Ah.
In the cartoon.
Hang on.
This box is meowing.
Let me see it. She wrapped up her cat.
Take it in the kitchen and open it up.
Then we'll have a cat running around the house.
You can't leave it in the box.
Why would somebody wrap up a cat in a box?
See? Because grandma gets confused.
Galena was in a big box. Hello.
Don't bring your mom into this.
They weren't just shipping one pair of boots. There were five pairs of boots inside the box.
Oh, so it was in the boot?
They were doing this Amazon try before you buy program. So it was a huge box. You know? And the weather, like, lots of factors made it so she lived. The weather wasn't too hot or too cold.
That's amazing.
The box was partially split open at one seam so she could get enough air.
Yeah, that's my next question.
Brandy, the Amazon worker, rescues cats. So she was there and knew what to do.
Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm. So she's got no serious issues.
Everything had to be just right for this cat to live.
Yeah.
And for me to not sit here and cry because a cat died.
Yeah, 100%.
A little peephole. A cat rescue lady, a couple of dumbass cat owners,
Everything had to be perfect. You'd think the box would have, they would have felt a boot was heavier. That's a weird story, man.
Yeah.
And then it got trucked, not flown, it was trucked.
Yeah. I want to punch that lady in the face based on her voice alone, somebody texted in.
But let me hear it again.
We got the most amazing, insane news in the entire world. I just couldn't even believe that she was in California. I thought it was a prank. Like, I still hard to wrap my brain around. She was trapped in an Amazon package.
And it was in this really big-sized Amazon package.
We had no idea. So Matt took the package to the drop-off without knowing that our dear cat was inside.
There's no way she talks like that all day. That would wear people out.
It's a lot.
She's a little too energetic. I will give you that. That's a good call.
See, we're back to the zookeeper sitch. We need a loadout gun.
That would be like if I was talking like this and the cat was in the box and then it got shipped off and we didn't know it. And then we found out and it's like, oh my God.
It's a lot.
It's more than you need.
The husband said like two words, didn't she? Did you?
She took his duct tape off for a minute. He got to speak. And everything was fine. No. Yeah, I guess. But yeah. I think she was...
I'm glad the cat's okay.
I think she was hamming it up because she knew she was on TV.
Yeah, I do too.
And I think you go to a different gear when you know you're on television.
I think so too. And the fact that she got her cat back.
That's unbelievable. That's, I guess. I mean, you know, you hear about animals get stuck in the dryer. Whatever. It happens. Not in a box, though.
Stuck in the dryer. It's a whole new porn thing.
You see here. Good morning.
The only way you get the pussy in a box, huh?
We were all thinking it. He just said it.
What my plans are for the weekend.
All's well that ends well. All's well that ends well, you guys. We found the cat that was in Utah, and now everything's fine because the cat rescue lady heard a little meow, 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 meow. There was a little people, and everything was there. Take a breath. Everything's fine. We now return you to regularly scheduled programming.
Hold on. Yeah, we need a...
Everybody calm back. Down. Bring it back to
Everybody
earth.
Calm down. In the woods. Nice.
Cicada. That is relaxing.
It is. It feels good.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.